Then we find that the Lord Jesus in the morning went into the synagogue. He taught, and there was the spirit of the unclean demon he cast out. Now in the afternoon he went over, I guess, for the noonday meal at the home of Simon Peter. We've seen that before, and while he was there, why, he healed Simon Peter's wife's mother. And my mother-in-law always called my attention to this. She said that the Scripture doesn't call her a mother-in-law, but it's always Simon's wife's mother. And I would always answer her by saying, well, that's a mother-in-law. And so that is exactly what you have here, a mother-in-law. And you could make a lot of stories about mother-in-laws. There are a lot of jokes about them, but the Scripture, for some reason, there's a lot of humor in the Bible, but there's none about mother-in-laws. Our Lord healed Simon Peter's wife's mother. He healed her. And it was a Sabbath day. And they would object to that, of course, but that he did. And you find out also that when he went into the home of Simon, why, he went there for dinner, and this woman had a great fever. The diseases were classified then as little and great fever. She apparently had a disease, something like typhoid. And he stood over her, and using medical terminology again, he used the term, be muzzled. That's the way Dr. Luke tells it, you see. And like wild dogs which have broken the leash, and that's what had happened. Our Lord took sin and dealt with it just like that. And immediately she arose and ministered unto them. You see, when Christ healed, it was not necessary to lead them off the platform. It didn't come about gradually. It took place immediately. That's the very amazing thing. I heard the record of a faith healer not long ago that someone attended the service. They said a cripple was led up there, and the cripple was led off. But somebody came on. They said they had an internal cancer. They were healed immediately of that. May I say to you, it's amazing how people will accept that type of thing. Why didn't the man that was crippled, why didn't he walk off without any problem at all, no limp? But if our Lord did it, that's what would happen, my friend. Now, somebody says, well, don't you believe in divine healing? And my question is, what other kind is there? All healing is divine. And that's what Luke's telling us. Doctors do not always recognize that. I had a wonderful doctor who was a member of my church in Texas, and he said to me, he says, I send the bill, but God does the healing. I can merely take out that part that's offending the body, but God will have to do the healing. What a wonderful testimony that is, and it's a great testimony. It's not your faith that would heal you anyway. It's not an individual. It's God, and God uses an instrumentality, and sometimes he does not. His instrumentality today could be a doctor. And now it was evening, late at night, and he went out from one to another, and he touched them. You know, Matthew, in recording this incident, quotes Isaiah. And I'm not going back over that, but you'll notice that our Lord here is healing in a very wonderful way. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. He bore the sicknesses and diseases sympathetically. In spite of that, the nation Israel in that day esteemed him stricken. That is the way we esteem him. He did not heal them on the basis of faith, as far as we know. His great heart of sympathy is what caused him to move in their behalf. And that's what we're told today, bear ye one another's burdens. Now, you'll notice that he was here, and he preached in the synagogues of Galilee. That's verse 44. He's bringing the gospel of the kingdom, that the kingdom of heaven is at hand in the presence and person of the king who is there. Now, that brings us to the end of chapter 4, and next time we'll pick up with chapter 5 of the Gospel of Luke, and I trust you'll be with us.